You can design forms to support data entry, summary reporting, and review. With this form, for every account, you can define the planning methodology used. Here you can set assumptions from a global perspective to streamline the process, while still allowing individual users to update assumptions as necessary. This enables planning by exception to minimize required user inputs and simplify and streamline the process. While it looks similar to a spreadsheet, forms are directly connected to your data, minimizing manual processes. During the planning process, you typically need to compare actual data with current or forecast data. Areas needing explanation because of significant variances can be highlighted with data validation. You can work with smart forms, which are planning forms that you create in SmartView. They are based on ad hoc analysis grids created in Excel. You can take advantage of Excel functionality such as formulas and functions to support business calculations. For example, in this grid, there are a number of formulas in the formulas column which get updated immediately when data is entered. For guidelines on designing forms, navigate to the Academy. Go to Design Best Practices. Then on the left pane, under Designing Your Application, click Design Walkthrough. Scroll down the content area until you see the topics on forms. Let's go over some tips and features you can use to manage forms. Separate input type forms from reporting forms. Design and manage forms with end users in mind. Data entry forms should contain a consumable amount of information for the users. Set up navigation flows to help users navigate through their planning process. Use dashboards to combine data entry and reporting forms to enhance the user experience by helping planners analyze results. When designing forms, balance the amount of information contained in a single form and the number of forms for the end users. Form performance is based on several factors, including network and environmental factors, as well as form design. Understanding how many data rows and columns are returned when a planner opens the form is important. Let's go over the best practices applied to this form. Typically, accounts or periods are placed on the row or column. Other dimensions can be placed in any of the form sections, on the page, POV, column, or row. Consider the total number of member rows displayed on the form. Consider the number of dimensions on a row. Placing multiple dimensions on the row will affect form performance. To reduce form maintenance, use functional relationships. Set up substitution variables and user variables for dimension selection. For form properties and settings, suppress missing blocks to improve performance if sparse dimensions with functions are used in the rows. Selecting the Suppress Invalid Scenario Time Period option aligns the form to the start and end year period set for this scenario and automatically updates as the scenario is updated. You can leverage this option instead of using substitution variables. Set valid intersections between different dimensions. Suppressing invalid combinations can be set in rows or columns to make only valid intersections available to end users. By default, only valid intersections will be available to the end users when the dimensions are set in the page selection. Use settings to control precision, display, and menus, and to associate the proper rules with your form. Let's take a look at options for business rules. For rules that may take a longer time to run, you can associate them with a form and not select Run After Save. Improve performance on forms with runtime prompts to limit the scope of the rule and use member selections to fill prompts. Oracle can only provide general guidelines about how to design your application and artifacts to ensure reasonable performance. You can use the application monitor to identify and resolve design flaws before an application is placed in production and on an ongoing basis as the application evolves with new members and data. Form design and performance are analyzed in three levels: good, fair, and poor. Here we see that the form design and the copy channel business rule are both tagged as green or good. However, we see an error noted for the revenue plan business rule. With this information, I can trace back to what may be causing issues on my form. and from there, troubleshoot and modify artifacts for optimal performance. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.